So grateful that you're alive today. And because you live, we too can face tomorrow. And Lord, we're so grateful for the cause that brings us together here. Thank you for this great group of people that's gathered. And Father, we're so grateful for the National Quartet Convention, that every year it brings together not only the greatest groups in Southern gospel music, but it brings together some of the greatest people from across this great land of ours. Lord, we're here this morning just to lift up the name of Jesus and to worship you in spirit and in truth. Bless these, our friends, the cathedrals, as they come. Lord, we thank you for George and his good health. We thank you for Glen and pray your blessings upon him. And Father, that you shall bless each of these men respectfully as they come on the stage now. And Father, just help them to lift up the name of Christ, that at the name of Jesus, every knee may bow and every tongue shall confess that Christ is Lord, to the honor of God the Father. But this we ask now, with forgiveness of our sins, in the lovely, precious name of Jesus, and for his sake I pray, and all the people said,
Amen. Amen.
My friends, I don't need to introduce this group to you, just tell you that they're here to minister to us. Would you welcome my friends, the Cathedral?
Thank you. just to say, Lord, I love you. For you understand I want to be there on that great judgment
We're so glad to be with you this morning, ladies and gentlemen. been such a thrill for me because, as you know, last year I missed and I thought I would never be back again because I had some, not only with my heart attack and open heart surgery, but I had some problems. The film showed the left side of my heart was completely gone and they were just going to go into the clinic and do what they could to repair it. And I didn't think I'd be out here again. I thought my singing days was over. And I look around and realize that I'm back with the guys that I love and I'm doing what I love to do. And I know beyond a shadow of doubt the only reason I'm standing here this morning is because of a touch from the Master.
Amen. The Master.
Thank you. her soul has heard many shouts. Now she trembles in the darkness when the mad wind blows a loud pain. Gonna need this house no longer, ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingle, ain't got time to fix the floor, ain't got time to all the hinges, nor even the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, I'm getting ready to get the same.
I'm getting chilly, but I feel no fear of pain. Cause I see an angel peeking through a broken window pane. Ain't I gonna need this house no longer, ain't I gonna need this house no more.
Time to fix the shingle, time to fix the floor.
Your breath. Speaking of these young men, let me do this. Glen and I, we're so proud of these young guys that the...
I hate young people.
ain't it wonderful when you get old enough you can just blurt out anything you want to? Just a few days will be 45 years that the old man's been singing. And 43 years for me, so behind us. And 45 and 43 almost adds up to Glenn's age. We are proud of these. Danny Funderburk, Mark Trammell, Gerald Wolfe is our newest member of the Cathedral. Gerald's in December. Gerald will be here 2 years, and so Gerald's been a blessing to all of us. One of the finest young men that ever come along. Had a great piano player, and. God has blessed this young man with probably one of the most powerful powerful voices to come along in our field in many years. Gerald is just an unusual young guy. He's from Morristown, Tennessee. We're proud of you. The second night I was back after I'd been out 4.5 months, we were in Boca Raton, Florida, Bible Town. Set the sound up. Wasn't nobody in the building, but the three young guys were setting the sound up. I was sitting on the back seat back there, really taking it easy back in those days. But I hollered up at the guys and said, "Hey, boys, sing me something to hear what the sound's going to be like." And the guys started singing this song. They had learned it while I was away, and I hadn't heard it. Boy, I sat back there and bawled like a baby. I love to wake up in the mornings and sit up on the edge of the bed. Now, especially at this time in my life, and after what I've been through, I love to wake up and sit on the edge of the bed and just whisper the name of Jesus. Not asking for anything. I just love to start my day out by whispering his name. Boy, they call him by a lot of names. They call him the Lily of the Valley. They call him the fairest of 10,000. They call him the bright morning star. They call him Master. They call him Savior. Won't you listen as the young guys sing a song for you called Daystar?
Lily of the Valley. Let your sweet aroma feel alive. Rose of Sharon, show me how to grow in beauty in God's
Let your love shine through. What's wrong, Andy?
Excited about what their group's doing, you know? They're just
excited about God.
Praise
God.
And I've been serving it for, well, I've been singing for a lot of years, ever since I was about two, but just really full time for the last seven. God has done so many great things in the last 7 years. And it doesn't get old to me. It seems like the longer I serve it, the more that I know about it, the more I learn to trust Him, the better it gets.
Amen.
Can I sing the verse of the song?
Help yourself, whatever you want. I'm gonna like it, whatever it is.
Yeah.
usually in the early morning programs here, or in the day, you stay away from your tenor singer as much as you can, because
I try to stay away from him as much as I can.
I mean, featuring him, you know, because it's hard to get up out of the bed and start singing. But they say, when you got a good horse, ride him. Kitchen, you know, and you're walking about like Tim Conway, you know. Think that's about as fast as you'll ever walk again. But I was sitting there, and I just slipped off my pajama bottoms, and I was sitting there in the shorts, and the leg was just awful looking. Glenn never been around anybody like that. He come in, back door, and I was sitting there, and he walked around the little thing. We got the kitchen, and he come and shook my hand. He said, "Oh, George, it's so good to see you." He looked down at my leg and said, "Oh, my goodness, what happened?" And I said, "Glenn, I've had open heart surgery." He said, "Yeah, but I don't know better than to cut there." Program right away with my wife, and she'd helped me through the walk with me through the halls and the bedrooms of our house. In December up in Ohio, you can't get out and walk. Snow is usually about hubcap deep on a Ferris wheel. And so my wife is helping me walk through the house and the bedrooms Of course, it seems that it was snowing back in, and we stopped at the big sliding glass door. We got there and look out. The snow was so beautiful. And everything was so new and wonderful to me. And I walked through the house for days and cried just because of God's touch. And it seemed like I could see that God's hand in things where I'd never noticed it before. It seems like I could hear His voice. Even I look outside and the wind be blowing through the leaves, through the trees, and it seemed like the Master was speaking especially to me. Everywhere I went, and since that day, everywhere I've been, the presence of God is so near, real and dear. I want you to listen to a song that a lot of times you're concerned with the beat of a song, and I like this beat, but I love this song. I can see the hand.
See the hand of the Father.
thank God that I can feel the touch of Jesus today. You know, you get into a track, sometimes it messes things up. But I want to say that I love the Lord with all of my heart. Listen.
I can see the high.
Set off for him. Harold Werder was his name, and he's from Tallapoosa, Georgia. And I was in the dressing room, getting dressed, you know, and I heard this singing start, and I stopped and listened because I said, Willie Nelson is out there. That guy sounded just like Willie Nelson, and I come running out there as fast as I forgot to put my britches on.
He wasn't as ugly as Willie Nelson. Of course, I want to thank the Lord for Willie Nelson. Because he kept me from being the ugliest.
I forgot to tell you, old Willie's sitting back there.
I still love him.
But when Harold started singing this song, he's not the fellow that you'd say had a beautiful voice. Back when he started singing, I looked at Mark, and Mark grinned at me and bowed his head, and I thought, oh, this is going to be a long course of a song to listen to.
Yeah, George Harold sits right down there.
And Harold sung that first verse, and it wasn't pretty.
No.
I'll tell Harold it wasn't pretty. But Mark looked up at me again, and he had a different look on his face. He sung the next verse. He sung four verses, and all five of us had tears in our eyes. Oh, Harold, just in a minute, was singing so pretty. Nobody would have ever heard anybody change from the first verse to the fifth verse. Start out so ugly and wind up so pretty. But
the Lord had given Harold a song. And Harold blessed our hearts with it. Let me quote you the chorus. Sin will take you farther than you want to go. Slowly but wholly, take it control. Sin will leave you longer than you want to stay. Sin will cost you far more than you want to pay. Harold ministered to me because I thought about when I went into the 82nd Airborne Division and I left a Christian home. Went to Fayetteville, North Carolina and joined the 82nd Airborne Division and bumped beside a little boy called Mousy Gonzalez from Mexico. Mousy offered me my first marijuana cigarette and I thought, yeah, I'm going to try one. Just see what it's like. In 1950, 51, 52, 53, 54, I smoked in them left-handed cigarettes, thought I was the toughest paratrooper to ever walk. Sin will take you farther than you want to go. The last verse, the last line on the second verse of this song says it all for me. I want you to listen to it. Mark can take a song like this and magnify the name of the Lord, I think, with this style of song that everybody I've ever heard. Sin will take you far, and you want to go.
As a child, I foolishly turned out away, not must face, but God in His goodness has let me return to share with His children this lesson I've learned.
Sin will take you farther than you want to go. Slow
Yeah.
We did a little bit of a cappella there. We've had some requests for this song. Mark, take your bass off and let's gather around here where we can look each other. I hate to turn my back to you, but I look better probably this way. But we had some requests to do this heavenly parade, so here's the key there. You start that.
Our traveling days were soon be over here, and we cross a rolling tide. For we're down here for just a little while, our home's on the other side. Ambassadors to Lord Jesus our Redeemer, and it is a love's crusade. For the right against the wrong, but soon we're going to come into heaven when the saints parade. For heaven's own king, for heaven's holy king, we let the rivers out and sing. Our blessed old story, story, glory, your heaven.
Peg McKinney,
Gerald.
Gerald wrote a song. He lives near where Peg does, so he took it over there to her, and he tells us about it. I said, and she recorded it. I said, he said, when he went in, Peg was in the kitchen, he went in there, and he said, I said, well, Gerald, how did you present it to her? He said, you know what, I didn't know exactly how to sing. I said, well, how did you sing it to her? He said, I just kind of sung it like I thought she'd sing it.
There's a Paul that is with me, giving all pills that's mainly when my troubles are near. I'm on hand. My face toward the crossing and the vision of Beulah's fire land.
Funderburk and Gerald gets on the bus and they start singing like people sing. See if you recognize this group here.
Super. Oh, I just love you guys. Well, you know, the rest of you guys couldn't come today, so
sing a song, and these guys want to help me sing it now. This is one of the greatest songs. Of course, I wrote it. You get to hear some good singing now. I know that. I ask for forgiveness when I was alone. Man, that's good singing. Enjoy.
Feature every night. Sometimes we try to go to a different song that we've been on our new record or something like that. But there's not a night goes by that we don't get requests for the song. It's one of those types of songs. And after nearly 45 years, I believe the old man here is singing better than ever sung in his life. I want you to listen as Glen Payne sings a fabulous song. We shall see Jesus.
We shall see Jesus just as he is.
Once more.
nearly 45 years, and the Lord willing, I got a few more left.
Danny starts off and sings a verse as only he can. Then my favorite bass singer in the whole wide world is going to take a verse. Nobody can take a song. We didn't come here to brag on each other. We come here to brag on Jesus. But I believe in giving the roses white and smelling. This song tears me up because I'm going home. One of these days to be with Jesus.
Yeah.
Simply in time, I'm going home.
Many times in my childhood, as we travel so far, by nightfall, how weary I grow. Father's arms would slip around me, and so gently he'd say, "My child, we are going."
Amen.
Yeah.
You know, since July the 13th, I've been so curious about every event that happened in the life of Jesus. Because you see, he's the reason why I have that peace in my heart and I'm going home. Starting from the time the angel came to Mary, he told her everything that was going to happen. When he was 12 years old, I'm just amazed the scribes and the Pharisees, the wise men, how much he knew. If you go on a little further, you can see him in the garden of Gethsemane, where his tears became as drops of blood. See, he was willing to suffer the agony. If it hadn't been anybody but me, he still would have done it, but.
Amen.
Then you see him as they go before Pilate. And because of such a guilt-stricken heart, Pilate tries to wash his hands out. And the crowd hollers, "Crucify him." Crucify him. He makes him carry his own cross today. You know? Lay him down on it. The Roman soldiers. His hands and his feet. They raised that cross to the sky and shoved them into the ground and his skin ripped, tears. He shoved a crown of thorns over his head, pierced his side. He asked where the ring was. Sacrifice. And he gives up the ghost. He's gone. And then they take him down. And this is what keeps going over and over my mind. Mary. Done this for you. What are you going to do for him? What are you going to do? Folks, it hadn't changed. He died. Put him in a tomb. The third day, he arose.
Amen.
But you see, he did it for you. And you. You.
Amen.
Now, what are you going to do for him? Gerald was singing.